The book I recommend that I have read is A Long Walk to Water. It is a book based on two stories. The first story, it takes place like the book, like one part would be the 1985 story, and then the other one would be the 2010 story. It would like keep on switching every chapter. So then it would start with the 1985, which is a story about this guy named Salva. He is a male. He lives in Southern Sudan. He has a family, and he takes care of like his father's animals. He went to school one day, and there was a war of north of all of Sudan, and all of Sudan and Southern Sudan. They were trying to make them all Muslims or some other religion, and they would fight, and it was a big war. Salva was interrupted by the war while he was in school. He ran into the bushes because there was guns and he didn't want to get shot. He ran into the bushes and like he got lost for some days. He found his uncle. So he found this one house, this one place, and it was like a little barn. There was an old lady in there, and the old lady offered him to stay there for like a while, and then the old lady had to leave because the people wouldn't shoot her. And then Salva had he didn't have anyone to stay with. He found his uncle in the forest somewhere, and he stayed with him. He also found his best. He also made a friend, which was later eaten by a lion. And then while that happened, in 2010, Naya, this one girl Naya, walks to water, to get water every day for her family to drink, so they won't die. She would walk like 4 to 6 hours every day, but just to like go over there and have to come back, it would take 4 to 6 hours to go, and then right, and then more to come back. Because she's carrying the water, so it would take more time. They didn't have much water. They weren't interrupted by the war, but they have a tribe that's called, that is the South. Naya is in a tribe named Nur, and Salva is in a tribe named Dinka. So, and both tribes had a long time fighting each other, and they in Salva's part of the story, he got to refuge campsites where he stayed because he didn't have a home. He got lucky and he got sent to New York. He found a family over there, and he was pretty much one of the sons, but he was like 20 something. And then later on, he started a fundraiser in New York for people in Africa, Sudan, to get water. And then Naya's story, she was walking for water, and then it collapsed kind of together, and then Naya's, she would try to get water, stuff like that. And then Salva got a whale, and he put a whale in the place. And then they didn't know that they were from different tribes, and then they were friends. And then yeah, I recommend this book because it's a very nice book. It's very interesting, and you can learn a lot about it.